caught up in the calling car, then, Lamont. Oh, any more men down there?
There's only the one, sir.
Ah, here he comes. Well done. Well done, Attenborough.
I love all this, don't you?
Do you know, this is the one place on earth where you can be up to your neck in hot water. The only thing you've got to worry about is whether or not you cut your toenails. Oh, sheer luxury. You know what? Some people get their best ideas in the bath.
Yes.
You can act out all your secret fantasies.
Oh, yeah. It's absolutely wonderful.
Mind you, you can do all these things with one small proviso.
Peter!
And here it comes. Yes, my love?
Even
then,
from here.
Oh, are they? Hmm. Well, don't forget to give them my kind regards before they go.
Peter, you can have a bath at once and come downstairs.
I can't. I've only just got in. I haven't washed my knees yet.
How could you be so rude?
I'm not being rude. I'm looking for the soap.
Look at this mess. Come on, out. Come on.
All right. I'm a big boy now.
Dennis wants to speak to you.
Dennis wants to speak to me. Oh, have you met her, brother Dennis? Well, why don't you go down and meet him, because you'll miss nothing here. I didn't think we need to come cap in hand, Sheila. He's as much your father as he is mine.
I'm quite aware of that, Dennis. I just felt it would be nice if you paid Peter the compliment of asking him yourself.
Compliments now? I've been looking after your father for 18 months. I don't remember anybody paying me any.
Jean, will you let me handle this?
But I mean, we're only going away for 2 weeks. Anyone would think we were emigrating.
We are not going to have any unpleasantness.
I should help him.
I shall put it to Peter in the true spirit of family friendship, and if he says no, I shall simply tell him what a selfish, dirty, rotten little swine he really is. Well, this is a nice surprise. We haven't seen you for ages.
Well, one of us had to make the effort. We began to think you'd lost our address.
Ah, funnily enough, we were only saying last week, weren't we, darling? We were saying we must pop round and see Jean and Dennis. Do you know what? I was having a dream about you only the other... Well, what night was it that I woke up sweating? No, it's all right, Jean, it's all right. I only mean it. And how are things with you, Dennis? All right?
Not bad, not bad. How are things with you?
Oh, they're fine, mm-hmm. They're fine.
Do you want some tea, Poppy?
Yes, please, I'd love some. Thank you. Sorry, I didn't get dressed properly. I just popped in a quick dip.
Oh, la la.
It's the trouble with having his and her dressing gowns. I always seem to be grabbing hold of hers. Pardon the expression. So, did you ever find out who it was? I'm sorry.
No, carry on.
Yeah, I was just going to say, did you ever find out who it was who borrowed your electric drill? And then I just remembered you said it was me.
It was you.
I wonder if I lent it to them next door. Because they're shockers, you know. They'll return nothing. What are you saying?
We'd like to come to an arrangement with you. Mm-hmm. Jean and I are having 2 weeks in Benidorm.
Well, it's lucky for some, isn't it? I know. You want to borrow my flippers and my snorkel, eh?
No, thank you.
Oh, you're quite welcome.
It's as simple as this. We want you to take Father.
Where to?
Here. Your house. We want you to look after him while we're away.
Why can't you take him with you?
Impossible. For one thing, he won't fly.
And for another, he's been living with us for 2 years and I need the rest.
I see. Well, when were you planning on going?
Tomorrow.
Oh, what a shame. I'm decorating the spare room. No, I am, honestly. No, I have. I've bought the gloss paint. It's out there under the stairs. Eau de Nil, £1.95 a tin.
Have you actually started?
That's my next job. I'm just cleaning the brushes.
I thought you were having a bath.
In the soapy water. They are. They're your brushes, I think, in fact.
They are. Brushes. Mm. Look, you can decorate a spare bedroom any time. Why can't you put it off for a couple of weeks?
Why can't I put it off?
Yes. Why can't you put it off?
Why can't I put it off?
There's no need for him to put it off. Your dad will help him with it.
That's true. It'll give him something to occupy his mind. Dad'll give you a hand with it.
No, it's all right. I think I better put it off. You're right. Yeah.
You don't need to.
No, I do. I mean, what's the panic? Anyway, I haven't got any stepdads.
What have you done with ours?
I lent them to next door.
I think we'd better move next door. We'd feel more at home than they do.
Certainly save a lot of fetching and carrying. Anyway, so that'll be all right then, will it?
Sorry?
It'll be all right for Dad to stay with you until we get back from Benidorm.
Yes, I don't think I have any objections to that, have I? Oh, wait a minute. No, that wouldn't work. I think we could... But I don't see how I can... mind you, I'd have to have a word with Sheila. Look, Sheila, with her... you to come over here and sit down, please? We want to ask you a question. Jean and Dennis and I, we've been having a little chat, and what we want to know is it all right with you if your father comes and stays with us for a couple of weeks?
What's the matter with your neck?
No, darling, I think I must have ripped it when I was in the bath trying to wash the small of my back. Let me put it another way. You have no objections to your father coming to spend a fortnight with us, with you?
Oh, so I'm leaving that decision to you.
Yes, you did. Yeah, that's right. And I said that I was leaving it all up to you, so we're back to square one. Look, can we sleep on this one?
Sleep on it? We're off at the crack of dawn.
Oh, well, you set the alarm, you know, we'll have an early night.
This is ludicrous. We're going round in circles. Sheila, I'll ask you. Are you prepared to let your father fend for himself in an empty house while we're away on holiday?
Certainly not.
Certainly not, Jean. Whatever gave you that idea?
Well, will you kindly tell us what you intend to do?
Yes, certainly. Will you tell them or shall I?
We'll tell them.
Thank you. We intend...
Yes?
To...
What do you intend?
Intend to look after Sheila's father until you come back from holiday. What time's your plane?
8:45 from Gatwick.
No, I don't mean going, I mean coming back.
I think we land around midnight Friday.
Friday, I'll meet you.
We can discuss the details when you call to pick him up.
Me call to pick him up? Well, we'll be off then.
Yes, have a lovely time.
Yes, enjoy yourself. Yes. Get safely back, won't you? Hey, send your postcard.
Don't forget.
Goodbye, sis.
Oh, bye.
Thanks for everything.
Goodbye, Dennis.
Bye.
Bye.
You knew that was coming, didn't you, eh?
I told Dennis that he had to get your agreement.
Yes, but you didn't tell me, though, did you? Like a lamb to the slaughter I was. Why didn't you tell me what was in the wind? You left me naked with no room to manoeuvre. And while we're at it, where are my clean underpants?
It's not unusual. This must be the airing cupboard. Oh, they could be in your sock drawer.
It's the trouble with this house. In order to get dressed, you need a team of tracker dogs. And talking of tracker dogs, why couldn't you go and stay with Neil and Janet? Now, she is his favourite.
Oh, do be reasonable, Pete. You can't expect Dad to go all the way to Inverness when we live just round the corner. Anyway, Neil's put his house up for sale.
Damn, why didn't I think of that? We're selling the house, of course. We won't be here. We're moving. We're going to Barney.
Don't get yourself so wrapped up. You know Dad thinks the world of you. He's always saying what a clever son-in-law he's got.
Yeah.
He never says at all. Sorry. My golf club, what are you shoving on the foot for? You have all the heads off.
I'm sorry, I don't think I've done any damage.
Give them to me and I'll put them over your back seat.
You get them on the back seat, you've got your fishing tackle in there.
I'll find room. Just you go and get the other suitcases and take the two paintings and the chair off the bedroom.
Sorry. Sorry.
You will be if you've bent my mashy niblick.
So, I mean, look at this lot. He hasn't come for a fortnight. He's removed. Well, it's hardly a secret, is it? I mean, look, this lot speaks for itself. Has he mentioned monthly rent or anything?
Of course he hasn't. It's only natural that he wants his possessions round him. He's very sentimental at heart.
Yes, I'm sure. But what I want to know is, how am I going to get this lot into the spare room without removing the bed?
Oh, we'll worry about that when we've eaten. Oh, darling, come keep Dad company while I get the supper.
They print some stuff in these papers, don't they?
Yes, they do indeed, yes.
Do you have this delivered every day?
Yes, it comes through the letterbox about 20 to 8 every morning.
Rubbish.
Are you wrong?
Wouldn't we have fish and chips in it? We need a proper newspaper as well.
How do you mean?
We need the Times or the Guardian or one of those.
But we don't get very much time to read in the morning, and we quite like that one. I miss all the news in it, and, you know, it's more like sort of breakfast entertainment.
Yeah, I've seen the entertainment.
Oh, yes.
Just don't fancy it with egg and bacon. I want to know what's going on, not what's coming off. Well, there's no news in this thing. Ah, I beg his pardon, here's a piece here. Four lines, tucked away under these two girls in the tandem. Now, you see, this is important. A government report out today reveals that by the year 2000, the native population of Great Britain will have dropped by 2.5 million.
Oh, yes, I read that this morning when I was having my cornflakes.
Well, that staggers you, doesn't it?
Oh, yes, it takes your breath away, doesn't it?
So what are you going to do about it?
People?
When am I going to see one or two grandchildren running about the place?
Oh, oh, excuse me.
Well, oh, well, I wouldn't know about that.
You should have learned by now.
No, no, I didn't mean that I didn't know, you know, I didn't know about, you know, what I mean, it's a big responsibility, isn't it, eh? And, you know, I'm telling the truth, I'm not sure that I'm up to it.
But can't you see a doctor?
Well, no, I didn't mean that I was, you know, that I wasn't, that I couldn't, that I wasn't, what I'm trying to say is that I find this rather difficult to discuss with you.
Well, when I was your age, I had two in school and one had a babe in arms. And I think we'd have had more if they hadn't stopped a free orange juice.
Yes, but you've got to consider what sort of world you're bringing them into now, haven't you, eh? I mean, you know, everything's so expensive. Have you seen the price of baby powder?
You can't put a price on the pleasures a growing family gives you. It's worth a lot to me to know that I can spend the rest of my old age in the bosom of my own flesh and blood at any one of three addresses. Now, you want to think about that.
So I'm thinking about it. It's weighing very heavily on my mind.
Yeah, what do you want to be shaping? Huh? Time's not on your side, you know.
No, it certainly isn't.
Where are you going?
I'm going to see if I can do anything for Sheila.
Be sensible. Have your dinner first.
Oh, God. I'm absolutely whacked.
Oh, I didn't sleep a wink last night.
Must have had more sleep than I did. I don't know what you were dreaming about, but you nearly had me out of the bed twice.
That's because I got out of my routine, haven't I? Do you know what? I was up here till 2:15 this morning talking to your father. Sorry, I tell a lie. I was down here listening to him. God, I don't think he stopped to draw breath. Do you know what? He went on about everything from what's gone wrong with the unions to who's behind the Butter Mountain. And do you think he stopped? I couldn't even go to the loo that he came with me.
Oh, will you watch the toaster?
Why? What's it doing?
The toast won't pop up.
I know the feeling. To be like me, it's a bit browned off. Brown, that's not bad. Listen, tonight at about 10 today, I'm going to bed with a splitting headache.
That's a bit corny. You can't expect to get away with that.
I don't know. You get away with it often enough.
Are you watching the toast?
Yes, like a hawk. As soon as I've had some breakfast, I'm going back to bed. Yes. Enough is enough.
Expect to have a long lie-in this morning.
Yes, I'm counting on it.
Peter, the toast.
The toast. The Queen, God bless
her.
Mate. African toast.
Oh, darling, you're useless. Look, I want you to take a cup of tea up to dinner. Ask him what he wants for breakfast, and then say that you'll take it up on a tray.
Oh, thank you very much. That'll be a nice little treat for me, won't it, eh?
Morning, all. You that toaster was wonky. I must say you got a bit of a jungle out the back there. What are you trying to do? Start your own safari park?
No, Daddy thought you were still in bed.
Oh, this hour, I've been up since 6, sir. Had breakfast washed up, had a shave, went down from the morning paper.
Oh, did you see, Mother?
Like a log. That is when I eventually got to bed. Did his young man tell you he kept me up talking till after 2 o'clock this morning?
I'm so sorry about that.
No, I enjoyed it. I can't wait till tonight.
I beg your pardon?
So what's it to be today, son?
Sorry?
What are we going to do this morning?
Well, I thought as it was sort of Sunday, no day of rest, I thought we could forget about it.
I tell you what, when I read the paper, you go and get dressed. In about half an hour, we'll nip along to the golf club. Right now, if we shape, we could get 9 holes in, have one in the clubhouse, and be back here in time for Sheila to have the lunch ready. What do you say to that?
Well, actually, I'm not very good at golf.
Ah, well, you're in luck. I'm just the man to give you a few tips. Now, you know that cup of tea, Grey, darling. I'll have it through here, okay? Hard for this first hole. A lot of people think they can get on the green in one. Now, I'm not saying it's impossible, but it's a bit dicey. What you want to do is get straight down the fairway there. Come to this side of those 3 big bunkers, and it's a chip and a putt in your own, right?
This side of those 3 bunkers, and it's a chip and a putt in my mind.
That'll give you a birdie.
Ah, oh, good. I always wanted one of those.
Now, what are you going to use to get there?
Ah, well, I thought that I'd use one of these clubs.
Which one?
Well, they all look rather pretty, don't they?
But try number 2 wood.
Number 2 wood? Okay, that's a good one.
Really, I borrowed this from my bank manager.
Sorry. Yes, I'll try to be a little more careful now.
Shall I go first?
Yes. Tee up when you're ready.
Right. Sorry. It's this side of those three bunkers, and then it's a chip in the front there.
Yes, good,
thank you. You will be a bit patient with me, won't you? I mean, don't expect miracles, because I'm a bit rusty.
Take all the time you want. There's plenty of time.
All right, thanks a lot. Right.
Excuse me, sir. Do you mind if I give you a bit of advice?
Not at all. I welcome it.
You're standing too close to the ball.
Am I? That's usually my problem after I've hit it.
Back to a fight. Yeah.
Yes.
Now, try that. Have you always used that stance?
No, only since I read Bobby Locke's book. And as far as I can remember, this is Fig 1.
This does for fishing rather than golfing.
Well, I do get confused. Now you come to mention it, I did get a book on fishing.
You never hit a ball like that. You'd have to be 99.
Right.
Look, get the club in a line between the ball and your left shoulder.
Sorry.
Right? Now lock the left here. Lock.
Yes.
Right. Now, swing back slowly.
Slowly.
Until it touches your chin.
Touching your chin. It's touching your chin now. The left has a
hopeless. Look, get your head right. Keep your eye on the ball.
It's joined under my neck.
The first rule of golf. Never take your eye off the ball till after you've hit it.
Okay.
Right?
Right.
Now, get the club in a straight line between the ball and your shoulder.
Straight line, ball and my shoulder.
Left elbow lock.
Left elbow lock.
Right, okay. Head down.
Head down.
And swing.
And swing. What happened then? I was doing so well up to then.
Listen, I want to know the truth. You played this game before?
Yes.
With a ball?
Definitely. I went round twice in the municipal golf course. I went round once in 76. I went round again the year after that.
I'll show you.
Excuse me.
This is your club.
Yes,
it is. Thank you very much.
It may interest you to know that it missed my head by a quarter of an inch.
Did it really? Why can't I get that close to the ball?
Oh, hello, Percy.
Dear, hello. Yes, the son and I were just going through a few technicalities. Do you want to play through?
Oh, that's very nice of you, unless you'd like to make it a three ball.
Ah, well, that wicket is moving. Is it all right with you, Peter?
No, I'd rather not. Look, I'll just carry for you.
I get more respect for my clubs. Why not, Hal?
Why not?
You're on. Okay, son, take one as quick as you can.
Take one as quick as I can, right. Where's the other part? Lost it. Found it. Yeah.
Where's your bag?
Sorry, good luck. It's in here somewhere. No reply. Look, this is just... Don't think they could have missed their plane back, do you?
Oh, darling, please don't worry. Jean and Dennis won't have got home till 3 in the morning. They'll still be asleep.
Well, 10 to 8, that's late enough for anybody to get up. I mean, they've had 2 weeks' holiday, haven't they? Well, I'm going to ring them again, and I'm going to hang on until someone gets up and answers that phone. Now, where's your father?
He's having his morning stroll around the back garden.
Well, get him back in here. He could trip over and break his leg or something. Now then, if I clap... How nice to see
Look,
you.
Look, I'm terribly sorry.
It's all right. Peter. It's all. Don't worry. You're here now. That's all that matters. Did you have a nice time in Benidorm?
No, it was terrible. It rained every day.
Oh, what a shame.
Now, look, Peter.
Never mind. We'll make up for it next year, shall we? We'll all go together.
I'm afraid you haven't heard the worst.
Hey, we never got your postcard, by the way.
Jean came back with chicken pox.
Oh.
You'll have to look after Father for another fortnight.
Oh.